Hello students, a very good morning to all the students. So students, we are going through our chapter 3, that is fibers to fabric. And in our previous class, we have completed certain topic like what are fibers and what are the different types of fiber. So students, I hope all of you remember that there are basically three kind of fibers. They are the natural fibers, synthetic fiber and the mixed fibers. So students, natural fibers are further divided into plant fiber and animal fiber. Students, in our last class we have completed the topic like cotton and also completed the soft topic, that is cultivation of cotton. Today we are going to start with the next topic, that is uses of cotton. So students, let's start. Cotton fiber are used for manufacturing clothes and linen. So students, cotton fibers are used for the manufacturing of clothes and linen. For example, socks, t-shirt, bedsheet, etc. are generally made from cotton. So students, clothes like the socks, t-shirt and the bedsheet are generally made from the cotton. Cotton clothes are comfortable in hot and humid condition because they are soft to touch, absorb sweat and let the air in. So students, we prefer cotton cloth in hot and humid condition for the following reason. That is, number one, they are soft to touch, they absorb sweat and they also let the air in. So the sweat absorbed by the cotton cloth evaporate more quickly due to the air it breathes. So students, the sweat absorbed by the cotton cloth evaporate more quickly because it breathes the air, which means it let the air in. As a result, it help in cooling down the body. Okay students, so now you see number 2. Cotton is blended with other fibers to make mixed fibers like the terricot. So students, cotton is also blended with other fibers in order to make a mixed fiber, that is known as terricot. The third one is, cotton is used to absorb blood and pus from wound and for other medical purposes. So students, cotton are useful in various kind of ways. First one is, cotton is used to absorb the blood. Second is, it also absorbs pus from the wound. So students, the meaning of pus is, it is a thick yellowish liquid that forms in and comes from an infected cut or injury in the body. So it also helps to absorb the pus from the wound. And also it is very much useful in other medical purposes. So I hope it is clear to you students. So you see, do you know the earliest written reference of cotton is from India? So the earliest written reference of cotton is from India. Cotton has been growing in India for more than 3000 years. So students, cotton has been growing in our country for more than 3000 years. But cotton was used by the Egyptian as early as 14,000 years ago. So students, in our country, cotton has been growing in more than 3,000 years. But in Egypt, it has been growing from 14,000 years ago. So students, I hope it is clear to you. These two are classwork for you. Complete it and then send it to me. Okay students, so thank you and have a good day.